Hi, I'm Jerry Regula, product engineer with McWane Ductile. In this episode of Iron Strong, we're going to a job site and going to do some repairs on glass lining.
Glass line products should always be handled properly in the field. Occasionally, though, you may get some handling damage or possibly some damage to the lining from a field cut. The good news is, you can repair this lining with a repair kit. It's a simple process. We're going to go through the steps on how to repair this lining. So we have our repair kit. You have the contents. You have part B, part A, the instructions, some sandpaper, a stirring stick, and a paintbrush. The first thing we need to do is prepare our surface. I'm using a wire brush to do the basic cleanup. You want to remove any oils, dirt, rust, anything. You want a nice clean surface, a clean metal surface to do your repair. So we have this cleaned up nice. Then we want to take our sandpaper, which comes with the kit. We want to rough up the edge. You never want to put glass line repair material over top of the original glass lining unless the surface has been roughed. And that's what I'm doing here with the sandpaper. I'm actually roughing that glass lining, and I want to overlap the new material over the old material about 1 inch in all directions. So I've roughed that surface up. Now you want to mix your material. You can mix one can to one can. As you can see here, we have a pretty small damaged area. We do not need the contents of both cans. So you can mix them proportionately. This is a 3 ounce can, and this is a 12 ounce can. So if you want to mix a smaller batch, basically 1 to 4, and you can mix smaller batches. You want to make sure it's mixed up good and you're ready to go. We've already mixed up some material. This material, after you mix it, you have about 1 hour to use the material that you mixed. Okay, and let's just give that another stir with our stick. Make sure we're mixed up well. You can use any disposable material or container, and then make sure you dispose of this in the proper manner. So we want to just apply this coating, and again we want to overlap it about 1 inch. Glass lining, the thickness of that is about 10 mils. Well, actually it is 10 mils minimum. So what is 10 mils? You don't have a mil gauge in the field. What you can use is the original material for a guideline. So when you put the new material in, you want to build it up so that it matches the original material, and then you know you're good to go. So I put one coat on there. You may want to put a couple coats, and you can build that material up. You want to make sure that the outside temperature is above 40 degrees. We have a nice sunny day. We're out in the atmosphere here. We don't have a confined space for any concerns there. So there we have a good buildup. So we have the same level. So we know we have the 10 mils requirement. The face of the pipe, you can see this pipe has been field cut. The coating on the outside edge of the field cut should be the same as the coating on the outside of the pipe. Okay, always keep that in mind. So we have our glass lining repair. We're going to leave this sit. You want to leave it sit for at least 24 hours, but drying time depends on the atmospheric conditions. You can use some air movement to enhance the drying. And again, remember, you got about an hour after you mix the material up. Simple process, easily done, project complete. And as always, work hard, work smart, and work safe.